Hello, Crossroads. We're in another episode of the Going Deeper devotional. My name is Kevin Deming. I am the pastor at the Hampstead location of Crossroads, and excited to be joining you today. Well, we're in our last week of the series, It's Not Me, It's You. I know it sounds bad, but the idea and heart behind that is really, it is, we want to break up with ourselves. And the idea is that so we can truly love other people, that that it's not about me, it's about you. And I've heard Reed use this phrase so many times, and it's that we want to make it a summer of others. And that's what it's about. We want to make our life about other people and how we live that out. Well, this past week was one of the loving one another's, and one of the others that we're going to love people with is the idea of encouraging one another. And as we think about encouragement, one of the best things to know is that it's difficult to encourage people if we're not feeling encouraged. I know that for me personally in my life, if I'm feeling bitter or frustrated or hurt by somebody, I'm less likely to encourage them. So for me, that would be an area of prayer that I'd want to pray, God, help me to overcome that, to trust in you so that I can encourage people, even if I feel hurt or wounded by them. But the reality of it is that there's a big fear. A fear in this world that we have, and fear basically is that I'm afraid that something isn't going to work out the best for me in a situation. But for us, one of our biggest fears is the fear of the unknown. And it's difficult to encourage people in that without having hope of the known. And so I want to encourage you today. The verse that we're looking at comes from Isaiah 46, 4, and it says this. And this is from God saying, even to your old age and gray hairs, I am he. I am he who will sustain you. I have made you and I will carry you. I will sustain you and I will rescue you. Now, I love this because it's a reminder of who God is, a reminder that God's the one who created us. God's the one who made us. God's the one who wants to sustain us. God's the one who created us to have a relationship with him. So if you have a relationship with God through Jesus and what he's done on the cross and trusting in him, then in that we now belong to God. We belong to Christ, and we have that relationship, and we can know that the known of the hope that we have rests in the fact that we will live forever with God in with him. And that's the known. And so we put our focus and our trust on the known so that when we face the unknown, we can be encouraged with that. And so for me, that's really kind of the hope of where we're at today, is that. It's interesting in this passage too, it was written to the Israelites because they were going through the season of unknown. There were wars waging on them. There was the world was crashing in so many ways, and they had so many unknowns on what the future would hold. And some of the people were turning, many of them were actually turning to idols rather than to God. And so God is coming back, and Isaiah the prophet was coming to say, hey, look, Israel, wake up. God is there and God is present with you. So I want to encourage you, wherever you're doing, whatever you're going through, whatever hard moments you have, whatever obstacles you're facing, I want to encourage you. The future is unknown. It is, of what's going to happen today, tomorrow, the next day. But know that God loves you. Know that God is there. He wants to care for you. He cares about you when you are in your womb. He cares about you when you have gray hairs and you're older. God cares. Now, what this doesn't mean, everything is going to work out exactly how we want it to every day. That we can guarantee is known, is that life will be messy, life will be hard, and it won't work out exactly how we have planned. But what is known is that God loves you. So let us continue to focus on what is known so that we can work through the unknown, encourage each other in that. I pray for you today that each of us will look to say, who are the people in our lives that we can walk alongside of and encourage through the encouragement we receive from others and from God. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, God, thank you so much for your grace. Thank you for your truth. Thank you for loving us. Thank you, God, for making known that you do through sending your son, Jesus Christ, to come to earth, to live that perfect life, to die in our place so we could be restored to you, knowing that, God, you're a perfect God and we're not, and we need you. So, God, as we face the fear of the unknown, the obstacles of the unknown, let us be reminded, Lord, that every obstacle we face is an opportunity for you to receive glory. And for us to trust in you, depend upon you, and know, God, that no matter where we're at or what we're walking through, you're there to walk us through that season so that people may come to know you and experience you. And we thank you for that, God. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Well, thanks for going deeper with us today. Excited about next week as we start our new series, On Your Mark. So get ready.